Yes, this is true. Eventually, the Muslims, those who have faith, those who have Islam, even if it's a tiny bit, they will all go to paradise. Now, the scholars may say other things. The scholars may say that only the Muslims are going to go. They're going to give their proof here and there. We are following not scholars of the books, but the scholars of the heart. Those who know Allah. Those who don't know about Allah. But those who know Allah. And Hazrat Rumi, Qadasullah Sir, is saying, there will come a time when the green grass is going to grow in the darkest pit of the hell. Meaning there will be a time when even the hell is going to turn to become green. Green is the color of what? Paradise. And that everyone will eventually end up in their original home. Our original home is not hellfire. Everyone, without exception, our original home, it is a paradise. How long it takes, maybe some people, it take 1 year, 1,000 years, 10,000 years, but eventually it will be that. And there will be the last person in the hell. Everyone has gone to their original home. The last one in hell is going to say, Ya Rabbi, just bring me a little closer. I'm in hell. Bring me a little closer too, so that I can smell the paradise a little bit. And Allah will tell the angels to move that one. And that one will stay there for a time and say, Ya Rabbi, bring me a little closer. And Allah will say to his angels, bring that servant of mine, that disobedient one, bring him to the gates of the hellfire so that he can see. And that one will beg Allah again, saying, Ya Rabbi, just for a while, bring me out from the hell, so I can sit outside and look where my original home is. And Allah then will tell his angels, by my mercy, take that one out and put him to paradise. And the paradise for the lowest servant of Allah, it is 10 times the size of this world. Because why Allah is sending Holy Prophet? To make us to return to paradise. Not for us to go to hell. Prophet is never telling people you are going to go to hell. He's saying you are going to go to paradise. He's calling people to paradise. That's why people are running to kill him. And he says by your own actions, you're going to make yourself to go to hell. Stop that. Don't. They say we don't want to listen to you from that time until now. 1400 years continuing. That's why the Prophet's mercy, his shafa'at, his intercession is there, not to put people to hell, to take them out from hell to paradise. And those ones who are following in his footsteps, they will intercede too. They will make shafa'at, and they will beg Allah to take those ones that are close to them, that they love, that are in trouble areas, to take them out and to bring them to paradise. That is the function and the job of tariqats, especially of the Naqshbandi tariqat, for us to do that. That's why we don't concentrate on miracles. Because every miracle that you produce, it uses up a lot of credit. Okay? You're going to use up a lot of credit. That time you're going to go to judgment day, you don't have any credit. What's the use? In this way, especially in Sheriff and his Jamaat, you don't spend a dime. You keep all that credit, because on the day of judgment, you're going to use that credit. What is that credit for? To get all those ones who are in trouble. You say you love your prophet, you're going to do exactly what he's doing. Prophet is taking people out from hellfire, you are going to do that too. You're going to say, Ya Rabbi, all this credit I have, I'm not going to use for me. I'm going to bail this one out. And Allah says, take that one. Understand the mercy of Allah. Yeah. That is what we are supposed to do. But don't think that if you don't have mercy in this world right now, you're going to have mercy in your hearts later. How are you going to have mercy if you don't know what mercy is? Knowing mercy is not just talking about mercy. Knowing mercy is when you are tested, and if you are showing mercy or you're showing anger. Having mercy, knowing mercy, is when you have the power in your hand to punish or to forgive, and you have been wronged, you have been oppressed, and you have the power to punish, and you're saying, Ya Rabbi, as you like. Because there is a time for revenge and punishment. That's later. That's during the time of Mahdi alayhi salam. Sending something, he's jolting. Yeah? There's a time of Dajjal, when there is no mercy then, that time here. But if you don't have mercy in your heart, if you're not being tested, everyone can claim, I have so much mercy, I'm very kind. You know, I'm very forgiving. You don't know me, I'm very forgiving. Don't say I'm like that. No. Really? I'm touching you a little bit and brrr, you get so upset. Huh? Men's and women's, especially women's. Oh, they're saying, oh no, I'm so nice. Ah, but you push them a little bit, they say, oh, don't do that, I'm just a woman. Why are you being so hard? I'm just a woman, you don't know how to treat women. Yeah, I know how to treat women. We are trained by the best trainer. Don't worry. We are not following the West, we are following Prophet. We are not taking the values of the West. We're taking the values of the Prophet. Yes, of course, Prophet, showing kindness and mercy and doing all of that. But there was a time that the Prophet ﷺ was so upset with his wives that he wanted to divorce all of them. That part they're hiding. That Prophet liked when he's sitting in their women and they are, sometimes, you know how women are, they pass their limits. But Hazrat Umar comes in, they all running away, hiding in the room. And Prophet is liking it. That is happening too. We are under one of the descendants of Hazrat Umar. Because that, for that time, it is necessary. After that time finishes, other times it's necessary. Other things to happen. So yeah. That's it. That's what we're going to say. You have to be tested a little bit, then you're going to know your worth. If you're not tested, you'll never know your value. You're just claiming. You're fake that time. Even gold, you need to test it. Then how you say that you have something higher than gold if you're not being tested? But people don't want that. This Jamaat is here to test. You're going to knock you wall to wall to test you, to clean you. That's why you don't see too many people running around too. It's okay, because people don't like it. They like to come to other Jamaats, and I'm just going to praise you, going to throw candy, just going to be nice, telling you about different maqamats and all these things, and everybody is going to be happy, everybody flying, everybody thinking they're a saint. But if you touch them a little bit, they're ready that time, if they have power in their hands, to finish you. Everyone has that, by the way. Don't put yourself out of it. Inshallah, we will not. Inshallah, we will get better. Okay, salamu alaikum.